In our Farm Basics section of the show, we like to talk about terms that farmers will often use that maybe the rest of the world has no idea what they are. And in some cases, maybe even farmers raising different crops don't know what those words mean. Today's term is the green bridge. Brian, it sounds interesting. Talk to us about the green bridge.
Yep. Well, first of all, it's not a road bridge that's just colored green. What this means is when you're going from one crop to the next crop, and you're going immediately from that one crop to the next crop, you want to, what we would call, eliminate the green bridge. You want nothing growing out there for a couple of weeks, because that typically reduces the amount of diseases and especially insects and mites that would carry from the one crop to the next crop.
We see this oftentimes in continuous cereal production, where there's a spring wheat crop followed by a fall wheat crop, and farmers just move right in from one to the next. And like Brian was saying, whatever was living out on that previous crop, whether it's disease or insects, well, I can just move right into the next one. Now, insects and mites would probably be the bigger concerns that farmers would have. But yes, you don't want to start off with a nice, new, fresh little crop with lots of problems like that.
The same thing can happen with cover crops. A lot of people now are talking about, oh, I'm going to raise a cover crop over the winter just to hold down my soil so I don't have erosion. And that's a great idea. We're not saying don't do that. But what we are saying is, if that cover crop isn't killed prior to seeding the new crop, you go right from green crop into, oh, I just planted a crop and now that's going to be green. And we've had that issue even on our own farm, like at our Ag PhD Field Day site, where we have mites that carry from one crop into the next crop, and all of a sudden we're spraying miticides where we never had to spray miticides before. We could have simply solved that problem by having nothing growing for a couple of weeks, and then we're in good shape.
Now, you see this so often where bugs move from one crop to the next, like for example with first cutting alfalfa. All right, you cut the alfalfa, now the bugs don't have food, they just move right to the next field and feed there. This is kind of the same type of thing that we're talking about with the green bridge. And if you say, I've never heard of this before, never had to worry about it, and I've farmed for my whole life. Hey, on our farm where we raise corn and soybeans, we raise a corn crop, and then there's 6 months of winter, or maybe more, and then you're planting a different crop later on. We've eliminated the green bridge with winter.
Well, so not entirely. Now, winter doesn't entirely eliminate a green bridge, and that's the whole point here. It's just that we've eliminated the green bridge because we raised annual crops that finished in the fall, so they're dead in the fall. Then we plant something living again in the spring. We don't have anything living over the course of the winter. That's the issue.
So the green bridge is something that farmers definitely want to take care of on their farm so they don't have problems from one crop getting into the next crop. But one of those problems that we could be talking about is our weed of the week. Can you identify this week's weed?